As the old saying goes, there's more than one way to pet a cat, and there's more than one way to plot your data. In fact, there must be 50 ways to plot your data. In statistics, you will probably use bar charts and histograms the most. But here are some examples of graphing that are not used very often, but are still useful to know about. I'm going to show you one chart that is very useful for count data, and another that we will use later with correlation, plus a third that has been called, quote, easily the worst way to convey information ever developed. Pie charts show data in a circle with slices of approximate size for each percentage. Pie charts display proportions or percentages. Therefore, the pie chart must always add up to 100%. You cannot use a pie chart for means or simple counts or any data that does not add up to 100%. And you must include all parts of the whole, meaning that you will probably need to include an other category. So here are some rules for pie charts. Use no more than 5 variables in a pie chart. Keep it clean. The first variable should begin at 12 o'clock and proceed from the largest slice to the smallest in a clockwise direction. The first largest slice of the pie should be the darkest. Each smaller slice is sequentially lighter. Arrange from darkest to lightest. Now, pie charts work best with a small number of categories, 5 or fewer, and similar size. So don't use pie charts when one category dominates and the rest are divided into multiple tiny slices. You can use lines or dots to shade the slices, but you cannot use color, per the APA Style Manual, 6th edition. To create a pie chart in SPSS using the Clickers.sav dataset, go to Graphs and Chart Builder. You can click the Reset button if there's still something in the Chart Builder. I'm going to use the Control click or Right click to show Display Variable Names. Now, in the gallery, choose Pie Polar. And we see there's really only one option. It's the pie chart. Drag pie chart up into the canvas. And we're going to use Group and drag that to the Slice By drop zone. Now click OK. There's our output. You can double-click and use the properties values to change the fill or the border or any of the settings for this bar chart. So when should you use pie charts? Well, here's the thing about pie charts. Just because you know how to create one doesn't mean that you should. As U.S. President Richard Nixon once said about paying hush money to cover up felonies, we could do it, but it would be wrong. You see, there's some problems with pie charts. First of all, pie charts are difficult to interpret, and they tend to distort the data, thereby displaying the data poorly. Area is more difficult to perceive than length, so the data will be less easily understood than if you had simply put the same data into a bar chart. In fact, Edward Tufte said of pie charts, "The only thing worse than a pie chart is lots of them." And Tufte also tweeted, "Pie chart users deserve the same suspicion and skepticism as those who mix up its and its, there and there. To compare, use a little table or sentences, not pies. Generally, avoid using pie charts." As Walter Hickey said, "The pie chart is easily the worst way to convey information ever developed in the history of data visualization." Almost every time, your best bet is going to be to use a bar chart. And never use the 3D option in Excel. Here are 4 equally sized slices. Notice how the red slice appears to be much larger than the blue, even though they represent exactly the same amount of data. And I would add to Tufte and Hickey that, like actual pie, pie charts are not informationally nutritious. I would never recommend using one in a publication, but they may have some limited utility in a simple display of data. For instance, here is a pie chart that I created last Thanksgiving. I do like that one. Now, a Pareto chart is a type of bar chart that arranges the data in descending frequencies, high to low. It's often used with nominal data to make comparisons between the items easier. In this case, we have the GDP for a number of countries. It's easy to see that the US is the highest and Japan is second, but who's third, fourth, fifth? It sure would be nice if we could just put them in descending order. Yeah, that is much better. To create a Pareto chart in SPSS, we will need to switch to a different dataset. We'll be using the dataset deathsinshakespeare.sav. Go to Analyze, Quality Control, Pareto Charts. Click through Simple and Values of Individual Cases, and then Define. We're going to move the number of deaths into the values box, and the title of the play will go under Category Labels. You should uncheck Display Cumulative Line. Now click OK, and let's see what that Pareto chart looks like. Now we can see the number of deaths per play in descending order. The bloodiest Shakespearean play is Titus Andronicus, followed by King Lear, and then Hamlet. In each case, you can see the actual number of deaths in each play. A lot of people don't know this, but this is also called a barred graph. Now, there's another type of graph called a scatterplot that uses dots. A scatterplot is a type of graph used for correlation and regression. And scatterplots are used to show the relationship between two variables, not frequency, as with a frequency polygon. A pair of scale variables, x and y, are plotted on their respective axes. A single straight line, called a regression line, runs through the middle of the data points to demonstrate the strength and the direction of the relationship between the variables. We will learn about scatterplots when we study correlation.